integrated disease management in sugarcane. Sugarcane crop is affected by a number of diseases. It is estimated that the loss caused by diseases in cane yield range from 15 to 20%. Diseases of sugarcane are caused by different kinds of pathogens, namely fungi, bacteria, viruses, and phytoplasmas. Among fungal diseases, red rot, smut, wilt, and set rot are important. Besides these, ratoon stunting disease, grassy shoot disease, and leaf spot diseases are potential diseases which can cause considerable damage. Red rot, caused by Colletotrichum falcatum, is the most dreaded disease of sugarcane. The external symptoms of red rot appear on the third or fourth leaf, which show yellowing and drying from margin to midrib. At advanced stage of the disease, the entire top, including the crown, dries and dies. When the affected stalks are cut open longitudinally, the internal tissue shows reddish discolored patches or lesions interspersed with white horizontal patches. As the disease progresses, the internal tissue becomes dark in color and dry, resulting in longitudinal pit cavities. Red rot is primarily caused through infected sets. The secondary spread of the disease occurs through rain splash and irrigation water to the adjoining area. Fresh surviving debris of red rot inoculum also serves as a source of further spread of the disease. Red rot disease can be managed by following an integrated approach. Select sets from red rot free area in order to eliminate primary source of infection. If primary infection is noticed, destroy the infected stalks immediately. Do not ratoon a plant crop infected by red rot. Red rot infected sugarcane fields should be rotated with paddy crop to destroy surviving debris-borne inoculum in the field. Grow red rot resistant varieties. Smut is another important fungal disease. It is caused by the fungus Ustilago cytaminae. The infected clumps are stunted and form excessive tillers which are thin and have narrow leaves. The characteristic symptom is the production of long, whip-like structure from the terminal bud of the stalk, which is black in color, covered by thin silvery membrane. This silvery membrane ruptures, releasing millions of reproductive spores of smut fungus, which are present in the form of powdery mass. The affected stalks are usually stunted. Often, infected clumps produce certain symptoms well before whip production. The smut disease is primarily transmitted through infected sets, and secondary spread occurs through wind-borne teriospores of the smut fungus. The disease can be easily managed by proper seed selection, roguing of smut-infected clumps, and avoiding ratoons of plant crop with moderate smut infection. Sets from smut-affected fields should be treated in hot water at 50 degrees Celsius for 1 hour or 52 degrees Celsius for half an hour, along with systemic fungicide Baleton at 1% concentration to eliminate the set-borne infection. The fungicide hot water treated sets should be raised as part of healthy seed nursery program and distributed to farmers. Wilt disease of sugarcane is caused by Cephalosporium saccharii or Fusarium monoliformi. The affected plant appears wilted and conspicuously stunted. The crown leaves turn yellow, lose turgor, and eventually wither. On splitting open the cane stems at the early stage of infection, diffused reddish-brown patches are seen. Later, canes become light and hollow and shrink. The disease reduces germination in infected sets, causes drying up of shoots, and subsequently results in wilting of the stalks. In severe cases, total cane yield loss occurs due to wilt. The wilt syndrome is predisposed by biotic and abiotic stress factors. Wilt fungi are weak, soil-borne pathogens. Subterranean soil pests like white grub, root borer, and nematode and insect pests like mealybug, scale insect, fungal pathogens like root rot weaken the plant and root system, paving the way for wilt infection. Wilt can be effectively managed by using healthy sets, crop rotation with paddy, and by application of organic manure in order to increase the antagonistic flora which can suppress wilt pathogen present in the soil. Grassy shoot disease is a phytoplasmal disease widely prevalent in all parts of India. Profuse stillering is a typical symptom with narrow chlorotic leaves giving a grass-like appearance and hence the name. The primary transmission of grassy shoot disease is through diseased sets. Grassy shoot disease can cause very heavy yield loss, particularly when planting material is obtained from infected sources. Grassy shoot disease can be eliminated from infected sets by treating the sets in aerated steam therapy at 50 degrees Celsius for 1 hour. Roguing and eradication of grassy shoot disease clumps are very helpful in the reduction of grassy shoot disease. Plant crop with high level of grassy shoot disease should not be ratooned. Ratoon stunting disease is caused by the bacterium Leifsonia xyli, subspecies xyli. Ratoon stunting disease is considered as the most important cause for sugarcane varietal degeneration. Diseased clumps are stunted in growth, thin-stalked with short internodes and have pale yellowish foliage. The stem tapers rapidly towards the top. When split open longitudinally, pinhead-like orange-colored dots of bacteria can be noticed on the nodal region. This symptom is very characteristic of ratoon stunting disease. Expression of the disease is more under adverse conditions like waterlogging and drought. Progressive yield decline takes place due to the disease. Primary spread of the disease is through infected sets. It also spreads through harvesting implements contaminated with the juice of diseased canes. The disease is known to reduce germination and yield. Ratoon crop suffers more due to ratoon stunting disease than the plant crop. The cane cutting knives should be disinfected with 1% Lysol. Hot water treatment at 50 degrees Celsius for 2 hours eliminates set-borne infection of ratoon stunting disease. The three-tier nursery program is also an essential step to contain ratoon stunting disease and prolong commercial life of varieties. Set rot or pineapple disease is common in germinating sets. It is caused by the fungal pathogen Ceratocystis paradoxa. Typical disease symptoms are detected in sets after 2 to 3 weeks of planting. The pathogen enters mainly through cut ends and proliferates rapidly in the parenchymatous tissues of the internode. The affected tissues first develop a reddish color, which turns to brownish black in the later stages. The presence of the fungus inside the set prevents their rooting. During the early stage of rotting, fruity odor of pineapple is emitted due to production of ethyl acetate, and it helps in identifying the disease. Set treatment with systemic fungicide, namely carbendazim, at 0.05% concentration is found effective in controlling the set rot infection. Integrated management of the sugarcane diseases can be best achieved by using disease-free seed sets, suitable cultural practices, and heat therapy with the three-tier seed nursery program.